Just to be crystal clear on this, does the president want a wall in exchange for giving those dreamers protection?
The president wants border security.
Okay.
And just to be clear.
Okay. So what does border security entail? Does it include the wall at this stage, or could the wall wait until later?
The wall is one of the pieces, as well as technology and a number of other things that have been laid out by the Department of Homeland Security. I believe that Secretary Nielsen spoke about that pretty extensively at the meeting today. That portion was covered by you all during that time frame.
The wall has to be part of the deal in order for these dreamers to have protection.
Border security does have to be part of this process.
I mean, there's a difference.
Why we
want
to secure our border? I absolutely do, because the safety and security of the people of this country are the president's number one responsibility and his number one priority when it comes to anything that he does. So absolutely.
But you understand how the wall could be different than border security, Sarah. Border security can mean agents, it could mean more fencing. It doesn't necessarily mean a physical.
And that's part of the negotiation that we expect Congress to have.
But you understand Democrats are saying that they may not be in favor of this kind of deal. That
if Democrats are in favor of protecting American citizens, then I think we've hit a sad day in American history, but I don't believe that to be the case, because as we heard many of them say as they sat around that table when several of you were in the room, they are committed to border security. They do want it. And most of them have voted for it previously before this legislation hit the floor. So anything different is just
a wall. If they say thanks but no thanks for a wall.
Jim, I'm not negotiating with you. I'm going to let Congress take care of that. Andrew.
Thanks, Sarah. I just want to go back to the question of Davos. Can you tell us a little bit about how this decision perhaps came about and what influenced it? Was there any part of it taken into account Xi Jinping's appearance there last year? He kind of seemed to take center stage and step into a kind of space that had been left open by the U.S.
No, I think it's about the president once again welcoming the opportunity to talk about the America First agenda, and that's what his plan is to do, and that's the main reason that he's going there, is to continue to promote and talk about that with the world leaders that will attend and some of the obviously leaders of the economy in this country.
His ideas.
Yes.
Sarah.
Does the president have a fixed set of principles and priorities for comprehensive immigration reform, or does he believe that that's something should be flexible on when it comes to that?
Look, as I've said, I'm not going to negotiate with you guys. We're going to do that with Congress. We've laid out what we want right now, and we'll make announcements when we move beyond those.